So back to the big picture. So you are source energy, and you project part of your attention into this physical body. And as you do so, now in this physical body, you're having life experiences. You know what you don't want, you know what you do want, and all day, every day, whether you are speaking about it openly or not, you are launching rockets of desires or preferences. In other words, when someone's rude to you, you want them to be nicer. But when you're rude to someone, you want yourself to be nicer. When you don't feel good, you want to feel better. When you feel sick, you want to be well. When you don't have enough of something you want to have it. In other words, life causes you to constantly give birth to new conclusions. And every one of you is doing it, even if you are a one-celled organism. And the expansion of all species, the expansion of everything that is as a result of that experience. But here's the part that we think most humans have a hard time, or at least have not yet done a very good job of getting their thoughts wrapped around. So you are source energy, you come forth into a physical body, and here in this form you give birth to new ideas. And this is the part we really want you to hear. Now, the source energy part of you literally rides that rocket of your desire and becomes whatever it is you are asking for, vibrationally. Now, this might not feel so meaningful to you because you're still looking at the manifestational world. You're looking around at the world that you see, which only exists because at one time it was thought and then thought form before it took manifestation. So when we tell you that the inner being part of you instantly becomes the vibrational equivalent of that which you are asking for, sometimes you don't feel all that excited about it, but we would if we were standing in your physical shoes, because that's the beginning of the creation of whatever it is that you are asking for. In fact, it's such an important part of the story of creation and such an important part of how you create your own reality that we've written a book and given it the best title that we think has ever been given to a book, Ask and It Is Given. And the reason we like that title so much is because the title tells the whole story. Ask and It Is Given. We wanted a longer title, but the publisher didn't think it was a good idea. We wanted the title to say, so I'm non-physical energy and I project part of that consciousness into the physical form. And as I come into the physical form, the life experience that I'm living causes me to constantly weigh the pros and the cons of what I'm living and give birth to constant rockets of desires. And when that happens, the non-physical part of me not only answers what I'm asking for, not only gives me what I'm asking for, but literally becomes the vibrational equivalent of that which I'm asking for. But they said it was too long. But ask and it is given tells you the same thing. When life causes you to ask, source not only gives it, but becomes it. Now, if you just heard that, then you have just found the key to the guidance within you, because these two points of vibrational relativity will help you always know whether you're on the same wavelength of that which source is. And this is particularly important when you remember what we just said, that your life caused you to want more of this, to want an improvement of this. In other words, you have incrementally been building this picture of your life experience even before you came into this physical body, and emphatically ever since, so that you have created this powerful beingness, this leading edge beingness that already exists, and source stands there being it, pulsing it, and law of attraction is responding to that vibrational state of being. Did you get that? That means as law of attraction is summoning to that expanded version of you, talk about a life force. Talk about inspiration. Talk about the stream of life. Talk about the call of source. In other words, are you getting a sense of why you feel compelled or inspired to move in the direction you do? It's because life has caused you, through what you're living, to literally expand and become more. And that expanded version of you now must be. Many of you have to croak before you let it be. We like that word croak. We try to be as disrespectful as we can about the idea of death, since there isn't any. Sometimes your life causes you to be this expanded version of you, but instead of letting yourself go to where you want to be, you beat the drum of what is, and so you hold yourself apart from your expansion, and you feel terrible while you do it, but then when you die, the gap closes. So we're wanting you to remember that Oh, there is no such thing as death, but when you have that experience that you call death, you release your habits of thought that are the only thing that are hindering you from being what life has caused you to become.